Hi subscribers and viewers of OWUUBII channel. I want to welcome you back to this other episode. So it's the continuation on how to configure or set up a P-Series Yeastar IP-Pbx system. On the earlier episode, we spoke about extensions and trunks, and I actually showed you how to configure them. So in this episode, which is the second episode, we are going to talk about contacts and how to actually deal with contact. Okay, so we are going to speak about like company contacts, phone, books, LDAP server. So this is for the episode 2, right? So kindly sit back, relax, and watch me as I show you how to deal with this feature. Thank you. So without wasting time, let's proceed with our configuration. So I said contacts, right? So contacts can be located at the left side of the interface. So click on contacts, you see company contacts. Let's go ahead and add contacts. You can also do an import, okay? You can browse and import any contact into this interface. So let's add a company. So I will be in it, okay? The company's name is OWUUBII email. Let me choose any. Okay, phone book list, all company contacts phone book. Okay, this is the default, which is the remark. OWUUBII networks. Okay, so if we descend here, we can see the number type, number and operations. So let's add our number type. It is business. So the number 02024880119. Okay. So this is it. This is the number I've assigned to this company, and which is a business number. Okay. So the next thing is the address of this company. So zip code, I'm in Ghana, so let me use Ghana's zip code 00233. Then the street number, Roman Ridge Avenue. Okay, the city, Accra. State, Greater Accra. Country, Ghana. And then you save. Okay, so now we have created a contact for one of the companies. We can go ahead and create more. So let me create about 2 more. So the first name, Gren. Okay, so Gren Rus. That's the name of the company. Then okay, so Gren Rus at something like this. Remark Gren Rus. Okay. Gren Rus Solutions. Then we add the number type and the number. So the number type for this company is business. Then we specify the number 023. Then we add the zip code. So let's say this is a Nigerian firm. Okay, Abuja Street, City Abuja, State Abuja, Country Nigeria, then you save. So we are done creating about two. Now, in case you don't wanna, maybe you have the contacts already with all details, you can just do an import from wherever location you have those things. You can just select them from anywhere, okay, and then you just upload and import. So that is it with company contacts. When we move further to phone books, and actually these are all the things you can actually do here, okay. You can otherwise export it as well, okay. You can otherwise export it and download and export, right? So let's move ahead to phone books, just right beneath it. So this is the part where you mostly have your phone books stored. Example, so if you remember when we went to the company contacts, this is what we saw as a default at phone books, okay. We can do a customize, we can change the name actually to what suits us. So you have phone book name, the members, which we can create more, okay. The members can be created. You can actually specify company contacts. So we have these members here, and then these are the list of companies that are part of these members, I mean the phone book members, okay. We can actually create more, but let's leave it this way. If we move down, what we can see the LDAP server, and a brief definition of it is, it's a protocol that is used to access directories. Discover how LDAP works, okay. So basically it's a protocol used to access phone books, and if it's enabled we can go ahead and create more, okay. So basically this is the company contact, this is the node name and not the domain name. So this is the company contacts and this is the domain name. We have the extensions and domain name, okay. And then if you move further, you can see the LDAP server settings. If you move ahead again, you can see the LDAP credentials, and these are the LDAP users, LDAP account username. So you can see this is the list of extensions we've created, and these are the corresponding LDAP account usernames, okay. So basically this is it with contacts under the P-Series Yeastar IP-Pbx system. In the future I'm going to talk about the rest of these features as well, like the auto provisioning. That is the next one to actually talk about. Okay. Yes, subscribers and viewers, so we've come to the end of yet another video. I hope you now have a clue on how to actually configure contacts and phone books and LDAP servers in our P-Series IP-Pbx system from Yeastar. Thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to like my videos and share my videos as well. And your comments are also expected. Thank you for watching.